All right, the stream is running. So, welcome everyone once again to Sound Goblin Thursdays, where I play random things and Krampus plays random things and random things happen. As always, I'm Vincent.
I'm Shiv.
I'm Hunter Grain.
And I'm Vincent. I refuse to not go last.
That's fair. Consistency.
Alright. And hot off the heels of almost dying, due to not resting, ever.
Look, sometimes just run into 10 burly shirtless men in the middle of the night. Challenge of the fisticuffs.
We finally get back on main quest.
What the hell did we just stumble into?
These aren't Soraks. They seem human.
What exactly are they doing?
What's it look like they're doing? They're digging something up.
No idea.
Just another dusty pile from before the cataclysm.
Who are these people? Scavengers?
Hard to say. I see no tent or flag signifying their allegiance.
Well, there's one way to find out. Perhaps we should sneak a little closer.
I thought you were just going to go ask them.
In and see how friendly they are.
Unknown humans, pile of things, some stuff. Something way off in the distance. It's more of a question of what's the most interesting thing we can find. A cult fanatic? Wait, what?
Cult fanatic.
He's just a fanatic about cults, not actually in a cult.
Kellis is giving away the game a bit too much.
Have you heard about this cult?
Oh man, have I? I have all this literature on them. They won't let me join, though. They say I'm too weird.
That fucking freak. That cult fanatic? Get away from us.
It's actually a misinterpretation. Misspelling. He really likes horses.
The cult fanatic.
Oh, I see what you did there.
No talking then.
All right. Kill them. Well, probably.
That's correct. They do not talk.
No.
We're just here to sell you some Avon. Quick, kill them. Fair enough.
Look, it's a safe assumption when you run across the guy proudly labeling himself as a cult fanatic. Not worth your time to talk.
Ah! here before I slide anything? No. Okay.
Do you guys see that glowing light over there?
No, I can't see in the dark.
Oh, fair enough.
You should go over here and attract attention. These are less tough than what we've been fighting.
Yes, these are just like low-level cultists for the most part.
Yeah.
We're not low-level, we're fanatics!
My point still stands.
Oh.
Fine. Low-level fanatics of a cult. Or of cults.
Thank you.
That's good damage.
Yep. Yay, Bardic Inspiration. Yep. necessary for now. I'm just gonna stab you. Ow! I'm just going to fail to stab you.
The way it goes sometimes. Sometimes you just can't stab. I heard a dude, a Krampus must have appeared.
Indeed.
Oh! The Krampus!
Sorry, in true girl fashion, I had to stop and ask basic questions about my local government.
Fair enough.
Take that ground. I'm coming to get you.
Gonna get you.
Burn to the ground. See if you actually complete the stabbing this time.
There we go.
Yay!
So what do you think?
It's a fireball.
They look like people to me.
Secondly,
what's
flame
that
sphere.
Symbol there?
The tattoo?
Looks like an A.
They all have it. Guess they're all part of the same club.
Well, there's no reason to assume it signifies something sinister.
Do you think it has anything to do with the Sorcerer?
It's a cult. Yeah, yes. Sinister.
That's an old Tiamarian symbol. It stands for Arivad. He was a Tiamarian god. But he didn't come to Celesta. I can't remember much more.
We'd better be careful. And don't forget, we need the head of a Sorak.
Okay. Yep, that was leather. Yep. That's good. Ah, find traps.
I like finding traps, but not with my face.
Okay. That was everything around here? Yes. Now to approach this, or now to explore this dungeon-like dungeon. More rations. Certainly need those.
Yep. Never have too many rations.
Need rations to rest.
Unknown human. A human in the Badlands of unknown reputation.
Sneak up on him.
Please don't kill me.
What are you doing here?
I'm just a worker.
Are you tattooed with an A?
You don't understand.
Are you one of them?
One of what? I'm just trying to survive. I had no choice.
You must die. Certainly an option.
Are the Sorax around?
Are the Sorax close by?
They're here! They're close! If they... No, I told you...
He's dead. How is that possible?
You know, of all the choices that would lead to death, that wasn't the one I was expecting.
He was doomed from the start.
I see footprints.
Yeah.
These will surely lead to shoes. And nothing else.
Nope, no shoes.
Ah, our true enemy is a cobbler.
It's actually a guy with a piece of wood shaped like a shoe who walks around putting shoe prints everywhere. Throw people off.
Consider me thrown off?
Push the rock.
Ah, crafty game. How dare you assume that I would pay enough attention to the interactive parts of the map.
I mean, it gives you a button to show you interactive parts of the map.
It does.
You can't expect people to remember things from a tutorial.
That was unexpected.
This place is topsy-turvy.
Remind me not to take a dump in that hole.
Do you really have to make jokes?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's in
yes.
My contract. Did Karen not tell you?
Might be good to remember what these blue currents can do.
Look, you can take a dump in that hole you want. Blue currents only levitate rocks? As you'll find as we jump through this blue current.
Yes.
Exclusively levitate rocks.
They must be ancient runes, or it doesn't do anything.
Look, you got no idea what Drab's been eating.
I don't think I want to know.
I'd say, not going to go up there?
Guess we could. How do we get up here? All right, that's climbable.
Yep.
Now they're leaving.
Oh.
And now they're leaving.
You clicked on the ground.
I did click on the ground.
This chest will certainly have something valuable in it, and not 4 or 5 rations.
Come on, less than 4 or 5 rations.
Survey says no ration.
Oh,
a handy haversack. This will be
a handy haversack.
That's actually useful.
I mean, it would be if we
if we didn't have the overflowing controls basically turned off.
It still applies.
It still applies. It's just our encumbrance currently is a joke.
Yes, yeah. But it can be sold for money, right?
Yes, it can be sold for
money. It can be sold for money. Okay. So getting back to the ground.
Also a primed crossbow.
Yes. A possible enchant.
She used crossbows, so that's semi-relevant.
Yes. We do use crossbows for now.
I mean, as far as ranged weaponry goes, that's basically what Snork's going to use the whole time, because he doesn't actually have proficiency with anything else.
No, his cantrip will eventually be more damaging than that crossbow.
Well, yes, but it's still, the cantrip doesn't take up a weapon slot, so he may as well have a fucking crossbow.
Yeah.
Can't get rid of enemies that are resistant to, elements. Firebolt doesn't do much against a fire elemental, after all.
Sure enough. Strange enough, crossbow arrows do, and that's almost more confusing. On the other hand, logic versus game balance is... Yeah.
Do we need to get into what elements are and aren't resistant to or immune to poison disease again?
Look at this place. I've never seen so many books.
Most books I've ever been in a library, but this, I assume, is big.
Must be worth a fortune. If only we could get everything back to Kaer Kiflin.
There's a guild for that.
The point of the scavengers now.
I was gonna say.
Why not keep this to ourselves?
Why? It's not like we can move all this crap.
You don't want a secret library out in the Badlands?
No, not really.
Fair enough.
Alright.
Clearly, he does not want to give the scavengers that 10% that they take.
Should I go down or across? Let's go across.
What happens if you fall down there?
What a try.
Door.
Well, that didn't do a damn thing.
Did you really think that would open the door?
We need to be smarter about this. Think it through.
Find a way to open the door. Damn.
You're not allowed to attack doors.
Apparently not. Fine, I'll find a path to destination. I will say this, it would be a nightmare to actually try and describe in a D&D campaign.
You're in a big, giant, ruined, underground library, bridges. Close enough.
Seems to be falling into a hazy void.
A hazy void. There are currents that only push up rocks.
Or for that matter, trying to actually build this battlefield.
Trying to build this battlefield would be the harder part, but I mean, really, if you had like some like roll 20 and spent some time in it, or just a mat, you could draw it out. It's just.
It's the third dimensional stuff that.
Yeah.
I mean, even the three-dimensional stuff isn't too terribly hard. For the most part, it looks like this is mostly on, like, maybe three levels. So you just use different colors to represent different levels.
Yeah, just put, like, you know, plus 20, minus 20. Whatever the height difference is.
Really certain we didn't need this to climb up here.
I'm with you on that, but at the same time, it's not the most egregious thing I've seen.
Fancy. She looks like an empress.
It was. She sure let it go to hell. What a pack rat. Her bones are probably buried somewhere under all these bloody books.
That's not the word that was in the text! You say the line right!
No, no, I must be properly British.
I refuse to say frickin'.
There's a principle here somewhere.
All this censorship, oh, so offended.
Okay. Gotta figure out where I'm going from here. Probably down this way.
So, out of curiosity, have you actually played through this campaign before?
Up through about this, a little bit after this area.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, in my own playthrough, I am a bit past this part. I'd say the first semi-challenging fight I had was actually coming up in this area. Granted, I did not have to deal with 10 shirtless men in the middle of the night trying me to fisticuffs in the middle of travel, so...
Do you think it has magical properties? By Aaron's bones, I think it's a spellbook.
And I should care, because?
A long-forgotten spell? A valuable secret? But it looks like it's locked.
Take it. Perhaps someone in Caer Cifflin will know how to open it.
It's called a knife.
But we have more pressing matters to attend to first.
Thank you.
in the Badlands.
Yeah, I know, I know. Expect the unexpected.
Anything past this looks like open door. Forgot to cross out.
You're not supposed to see that.
Destination. Here, I don't think now.
No. Way too long a jump.
Yeah. Or explore it this way. Came from nothing down here, really. It's just to, over to here. Oh.
Pardon, bro, it's all of a sudden kind of tickly.
Okay.
You see that? Is that a Sorak?
You think everything's a Sorak?
I don't think so.
No idea.
Say so.
Stop losing time. It's just a statue.
Look, can't just claim everything to Sorak now you know Soraks exist.
Fine, it's not like there's spiders in this game.
We do have spiders in this game. We've already fought spiders in this game.
Yes, I know. which way first? Let's not split the party.
I mean, in fairness, the one that was off on his own is the one least likely to actually get hit. This is just puzzle unlocking stuff and not any sort of progress other than that. Spiders.
Spiders.
They sure are in spots. Take that. Not shoot the same one, just not currently have line of sight to anything. Anything. Okay. It is not. Let me select that space.
Finicky selection.
It's because of the verticality. You're still on the lower layer. You need to.
Okay.
It's a really finicky interface. You need to move it. Yeah, there you go. It's a whole thing where it's when it's divided across vertical spaces like that, it puts sort of a lock into the first vertical set of spaces you touch. So you need to move the mouse outside that and then. Might be able to hit multiple with the breath weapon.
Almost certainly. Rain 2 no matter what I do. Yeah, the green like 2.
Yeah, well, I would prioritize hitting the spectral spiders with that kind of stuff, just because they're resistant to weapon damage. Yeah.
Let's see if I can swing through some of these Badlands spiders to get some damage off of them.
Yeah.
That must have hurt.
Yeah. Ow, 2 damage. Cells line sight or something. Take that wall. Anyway.
Show that wall who's boss. Wall knows what it did. Could be harboring more spiders.
It's been standing in your way for too long.
Take out that wall, we could bring this whole place down.
I mean, that would kill all the spiders here.
Exactly.
I mean, we'd be taking out two, but just think of the benefit to the world of getting rid of all those spiders.
Too slow.
Mana, Evo. Malmis.
Take that 3 damage.
Again! Harder!
Victory, and I'm only moderately filled with poison.
A little bit of poison never killed anyone. That's not true at all.
I owe you one.
Arcana Evo Cure.
Okay, so I think we determined there's Bumpkiss else down there. Enough of that. I don't know where all those places where you need like spider climber levitation to get to.
It might be close enough for Misty Step, but you'd have to use 2 of them, which is ugh. Basically, be all the second level spell slots.
Probably not worth it. We'll get spider climb eventually. We can sweep back through.
Check our scrolls. We may have a scroll spider climb.
I think we used it to try and learn spider climb.
That is a possibility.
Yeah, I don't think we required another one.
Yeah, okay, we can always come back here, like the location actually goes away.
Yeah. Let's see.
Another statue.
These guys really love themselves.
Oh my god, you see it.
My god, we actually figured something out.
He's an emperor. A famous one, too.
It had to happen eventually.
He was emperor at the time of the cataclysm.
Good job managing the trouble, mister.
Cataclysm? Oh, that's when Deathwing showed up. There, I've made a required joke of an MMO. I'm done for the night.
We have successfully retrieved 1 of 4 clues.
All these books floating around and I can't grab them.
Magnificent short bow.
And a ring of some sort.
A gold bracelet.
Just money.
Yeah, basically. Alright. Definitely looks like a something.
What kind of runes are those? Enchanted runes. From the ancient imperial period. It is said they had 8 schools of magic. Each is represented here, all as equals. This place is astounding.
We weren't sent here to find runes. We were sent to find Sorax.
Once again, you think everything is a Sorak? These runes could be Soraks. Knew it. They're being really generous when they call us a puzzle, by the way.
Yes.
I stepped on some magical rune.
guess there's a reason for that.
Can you find and step on all four runes?
Man, that sounds tough. I'm not sure if I can do it.
Can you find the runes in this picture before Johnny Bravo does?
Oh, not there. Oh, one more rune.
How to find that rune. It's definitely somewhere.
Yep, it's definitely somewhere.
I'll tell you where it isn't.
It's in the area of all the other runes. You don't have to go look around the map for it.
It isn't there.
Okay.
You can literally see it shining under the other rock.
Yeah. Congratulations, you solved the puzzle.
Very half-hearted doo-doo, you found it.
Seek a way in.
We did it!
Was that insane puzzle the work of some long-dead Manakalan wizard?
Probably. Even from the tomb, that magical arsehole is messing with us.
I built this a puzzle for my children. I need to keep them busy.
There's just milk and cookies inside. First press that worked. First and foremost. Screw it, I don't care if I run into more spiders. Acuteness, short sub acuteness, some prime stuff. Now let's stare at this open door.
Yep. That is a door. It is open.
There we see. There's a plate teller over here. Second most. Or the most, you know. Sneak up on this campfire. Make sure it doesn't get away.
Oh, that's right. They were nice enough to give you an actual long rest spot here. Okay. You could have ran over and tried to do Misty Step first to do that chest.
That's fine.
Spells. I think we're pretty much good on those. Okay. Alright, it's been 16 hours. Silent. Alright, stealthy.
Quiet, quiet.
Stay hidden. They're here.
Zorax.
Are you
sure?
What else
could they be?
Ready to do this.
Get in position, hit him hard, and take him by surprise.
Ready.
Okay.
Here's a room full of Zorax.
How full is this room of Zorax?
There's a decent number of Zorax.
There's one right there, too. Just climb walls.
No, I'll let the spider climb.
Alright, this seems like a decent setup. Okay. What'd I do? Oh, does the invis.
It's the invis.
On the bright side, I can see invisible.
Yep. That's good.
It's not It's just out of range is what it is.
Yeah. You need to be up a little bit, like on the stairs to fire it off. Now wait for that guy to path back over.
Yep.
Just a couple of them failed their saves.
Yep. The ball of fire.
The spicy, not quite meat, a ball.
Oh, it's still self.
Yep. Side. That's caster.
Your contenders. Yes, that is a caster. Acolyte of Sokhtar.
Yep.
Sounds like an insult.
When I was doing this fight in my game, the monk that I had missed that guy that's up there like 5 times in a row. He refused to roll higher than a 4.
Oof.
Good ball of fire. Should be out of range of a crossbow.
Or don't have lines. Not out of range, just out of line of sight.
Ah.
Line of effect.
Yeah. Power to still be sneaky.
Yeah, you sure can fly. Take that wall. I don't know if these count as humanoids. Yes, I do. And it lost concentration. And you know what else?
Yes, burn!
Hey, so just putting it out there, this is exactly the kind of fight where it'd probably be pretty good to turn on Andre's fucking channel divinity.
Maybe.
It is. Probably should have done that earlier. That problem is we'll take his action for the turn.
As opposed to getting an ineffectual shot on the guy?
That may kill him.
He's got disadvantage.
Okay, now I don't have to worry about caster. Likely, and I don't actually care if you break. Sure.
Gotcha.
There we go. But yeah, before the fight starts, I should have actually turned it on.
Yeah. I
need to remember that in the future. Thank you. Oh, range 6, not 12. That's why. Right then. Well, this has been working well so far. I'm coming. Take that partial damage. Pillar was unimpressed.
They didn't die easily.
Thankfully, we prevailed.
Now, just need one of their frickin' heads.
This isn't a Sorak, this is just a regular lizard man. Do you people even know what a Sorak looks like?
Like a lizard man, but spiky? Yeah. Well, this is clearly important. Anyways.
Maybe, I don't know.
You idiots, you've killed their stunt doubles!
After the storage chest I tastefully avoided. Prime chain shirt. A doom gem. What could this possibly be?
You look at this. A crown of some kind? They seem to keep their distance from it.
Maybe it's cursed.
Look what I found.
Let me take a look. Looks like ancient Temarian. If you find it, send for... This appears to be a name.
That has to be a Sorak name.
They were protecting it. It must be of great value to them.
The choices.
Who wants the crown? Who wants the crown? Ooh.
Let's see. So, the mysterious crown is right over here. Revive once per day, raise dead.
Yes, for
saves.
It's not per day, it's charges.
Yeah, it is charges.
It gets charges. And then it also gets like plus one to saves, like plus one to resistances. It's a minor plus bonus for the rest of the campaign.
Yeah. I think I am going to put this on Andre.
Yep, just make him even more impenetrable.
Take it then.
Sure.
It also is bonuses to intimidation and persuasion.
Yes. Yeah. I understand. So who are you talking to? Wait, what are you doing?
Are you crazy? Why did you put it on?
We have no idea what it does, whether it's evil or anything.
What? I just kind of had to.
We're supposed to share the loot, by the way.
Perhaps we should rest.
Right, break it into four.
I say we go before the owner of that unpronounceable name shows his ugly face. The mission is done after all.
The name's Earl.
Is it? Did someone cut off a...
Can't pronounce that! We have the crown.
Right,
smash cut to title screen. Smash cut to credits.
The sooner we go, the sooner we can get back to
Earl. Because Earl has three silent ages.
I'll see you, friends.
Completely unpronounceable.
We found it. The crown of the Magister. Game it.
All right. So now we are basically done-ish with this place, but can go back up top
to... Yeah, if you have two spell slots, you can try to the Misty Step. I think you only need one Flaming Sphere, so you should have two second level slots left.
Yes, I think cast Flaming Spear and then shot a crossbow a bit.
Hey, the tactic works.
I mean, wizards are basically Batman. You deploy something from your prep time belt and then you're basically good.
Oh, actually, that's like the thing you can knock over to get back over if you only need one Misty Step.
No. Oh, that's what you're saying, two Misty Steps. Yeah.
Yeah. I think one to get there, one to get back, but...
Yeah, I think it's intentional, so you can't trap yourself.
Yeah.
Alternatively, so you can like send a mage over there, have them
that's
knock
right,
the thing
that.
Over, and
that's right,
yeah,
that's
there.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right,
come back.
Yeah.
And yeah, the other factor of that being, you can also just have like a mage or somebody go over there, knock the thing over, and then have your rogue character actually deal with the chest in case of traps or whatever.
Yeah.
There's a chest right there. Yeah. Oh, no path to destination. That, seems accurate.
Is he our longest jumper?
Yes. Yeah, he's...
Yeah, I always try and do those ones with whole party, because someone made to be able to do it.
That's pretty much going to say the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. But yeah, back to getting out of here. Ground room, long rest safe area, library. Yep. Excavation sites.
Ah, there's an enemy mist in the camp.
Oh. Yep.
A basket. It could have food rations.
Probably has food rations.
A second crown of the Magister.
Had food rations. And a tragic love letter.
All right. Gotta get out of here. reason to travel anywhere else.
I can't wait for us to get assaulted by a bunch of shirtless men on our way back, so we don't have any spell slots during a fight.
I'm sure the game wouldn't throw this at it twice.
No. Oh, we have spell slots. It wouldn't actually have been
a troubled night.
But ours, take the crown off. Andre will not take the crown off.
You look a little pale. Is something wrong?
I don't feel too good.
Shit, I knew that hunk of junk was cursed.
You don't know that.
Just get rid of it.
No, we need it.
Need it? For what?
For its
the plot.
Power. I can feel it deep inside.
So the story can happen.
I just need to rest for a bit. Yeah, I'm not feeling too good either.
Are you okay? That bag under your waist appears to be clipping in and out of your body.
Fine, let's rest for a while. Set up camp.
He's practically a ghost already.
Ah,
a scout and a wolf.
Like five scouts and four wolves.
Five scouts and four wolves, yes. Scouts and wolves. I'm pretty sure the wolves have the same exact stats like the ones we fought in the tutorial in the first camp ambush.
That must have hurt.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't really level stuff up in this game so much as just throw
more of it.
Like new, either more of it or things with new suffixes or prefixes to change what they are. Much like how the Sorok we fought so far are like five or six different Sorok.
Yeah.
Things.
Arcana. Evo Diribe.
Oh, it's just out of range of attacking things. Okay.
Didn't get me.
you lose.
Not but taking this all up more quickly, so. Closer or something. At least that's my guess.
For what now?
It's not letting me attack with the spear.
Ah, yeah, it might be out of your range.
There it goes.
Ow! Come on, you can do better.
Really want that campfire.
Deal with it.
Good, I can stop you some bows. Okay.
Maybe this is like the thing, or the opening of the thing, where the guys in the helicopter are trying to warn them about the monsters, but nobody speaks Icelandic. Campfire, it's a Sorak, watch out! I don't think they understand us.
You die, can't just say us. Everything's a Sorak.
We can, it's just...
Sounds like something a Sorak would say.
I was gonna say... That sounds like I don't know what you're talking about. Questioning that sounds like something a Sorak would say.
Look, all I'm gonna say is, if everything is Sorak, then nothing's a Sorak, okay?
Oh.
You can't just keep calling everything Sorak.
Now you've figured out the insidious plan of the Sorak.
And our secret most defended character, the mage.
Yeah, you have your shield spell. More. The shield spell, the ability to say no.
That's battle.
That puppy was very clearly the thing.
All right, you're here. That was way more effective than I was expecting that to be.
Like a max damage roll?
Yeah. More than 11 AC.
Not an ogre.
It's probably like 12 or something.
Got ya.
No, it's more than 11 and less than 23.
More than 11, less than 23.
We're figuring out the range.
It's like 13.
Makes sense. They're probably wearing like leather and have some amount of dex, considering they are scouts.
Nice move.
Go over here. Oh, this safe spot in the middle of this dry brush. Yay, arrows. That was it. Yep. All right, back to that rusting thing. Or something.
All right, now we're going to get into our comfy bed rolls, and oh, it's eating me! Oh, we were the bedrolls the whole time.
Gross, you Zorak.
Go to the Gravekeeper's Cask. I think it's literally just right. Doesn't matter where we go.
Against all odds, we have recovered proof that Sorak's do exist.
How do you feel?
Better.
Maybe that sickness was nothing.
What about the crown? You know the council will probably take it. No! We can't hide the fact that we found it with the Sorak's. It's our loot. Ours! We have to declare it
historical
value. And they have the right to buy it. And if it's priceless?
Come on, they can do whatever they want.
Sure. We must wait and see. And hope for the best.
They'd better remember that we fought the Sorak's for this.
All right. To the end.
Lord Karen.
Ah, deputies. I see you found some nice, shiny loot. So, have you brought us the head of a Sorak?
One head, slightly damaged.
Marike, preserve us. I'm sorry I asked.
At least it's dead. You should have seen it alive.
I can only imagine.
When's the next council meeting?
When? But now, of course. The rumor of your return has already reached the palace. They're waiting for you.
They are?
Well, more for this.
They actually expected you to die.
Now there's a trophy. And by the way, who's crazy now?
All right, you were right.
Yes, you. You're crazy. We know.
Great guy from the CW.
I've seen more than anyone in this town, yet nobody seems to believe me.
Maybe it's a curse.
The curse of being surrounded
by Doug Winchester.
If you don't mind, Merton, we have business to attend to.
Right. Say hello to the old lady for me, Karen.
Who is this guy again?
Arwin Merton. He used to be a legend. The first scavenger, they say. But now, well, you can see for yourself.
Who's this old lady?
Just ignore him. Let's go.
All
Your thoughts, Dean Fasek?
Well, it looks very much as the scriptures describe.
Well then, it seems we have a problem.
It's a disaster. We all know what the Sor-Akat did on Tirmar.
There's something else.
What?
A crown?
Interesting. Very nice find.
We don't want to sell it.
Why not? You know we pay well.
We want to keep it.
I'd like to take a look at it, though.
Come on, let them take a look.
Thank you. No, mine.
Any ideas?
It's quite massive. Clearly imperial in style.
These ruins remind clearly me of the imperial schools of magic.
I have a spell I'd like to cast on this.
Wow.
My lords, this deputy is clearly unwell.
What?
You want to say it to my face?
This deputy is clearly unwell and now laying on the ground. Someone put a blanket over him. He's taking a nap.
I feel happy!
What happened?
You passed out.
Where are we?
The Temple of Aenar. Marshal Beric Sunblaze himself invited us to stay here. We certainly made an impression on the Council. They believe you're attuned to the crown, that you can't be separated from it.
What? So...
sounds like bullshit to me!
He's cursed!
They're not sure. All these big brains and they're stumped. They cast spells on the crown, on you.
Between that and the Sorax, we caused quite a fuss out there. They'll reconvene the council when you're ready. But trust me, there's a lot of people who want to talk to you first.
Yep, there's a room.
Uh-huh.
And that's a statue.
Look at our candle collection.
Do we have to?
Lord Sunblaze, thank you for your hospitality.
It's the least we can do for the deputies who proved that there are still Sorax on Celesta. You've proved we cannot relax our vigilance. Did you find anything else that could help us track them?
There was a parchment.
If you find it, send for the char.
You can read that.
That last word, it's not Temarian. It's in the Sor-Akat tongue.
I knew it!
Oh, you're a Sorak! We knew it!
General, you were wise to run.
Also, the fanatics we fought near that old tower. They all had this tattoo on their arm. It seems to support the idea that they were working for the Sorax under duress.
It is indeed one of their ways. Now this is the A of Erevat.
Can you enlighten us?
Between the myth and what we've seen, it's confusing.
Of course. We paladins and clerics of Aenar are the guardians of these memories. Our ancestors fought the war against the Sor-Akath. Their god, Sor-Tar, gave them dark powers of treachery, mind-reading, and shape-changing. They infiltrated the human society, corrupted the hearts of men. At some point, everyone was suspected to be a Sorak in disguise. Distrust broke humanity. Sor-Tar had won. He corrupted even Erevat, god of the Inquisitors. The gods themselves decided to run away from Tirmar. They opened the rift for the humans to escape to Celesta. Many of them didn't make it. It was a tragedy. At the site of the rift, thousands of Sorak tried to cross. Sor-Tar himself tried. The rift was closed,
in a gigantic blast. Our kings and heroes, Manicallon's masters of magic, were all wiped out. So, how could Sorax have survived, escaped, and then thrived on Celasta? I suppose that's another one of their tricks. But for those who had survived the war, the Exodus, it was paramount to stay vigilant, to keep the memory alive. The memory of what Sorax were, what they could do, so that if one day they were to return, we'd be ready. I'm sorry to say, after 1,000 years, only a few of us remain. Now, most people believe Sorax are a mere legend. But you brought us proof the Sorax are not extinct.
I think this is just ask some questions be done, so yeah. Let's start down the list.
How do they get people to worship them?
They get into people's minds, learn their darkest secrets, their fears, their shameful desires. With that, they can blackmail, corrupt, and finally, recruit. It's much easier for them than to duplicate, and very efficient.
We fought different ones. Do you know more?
The bulk of their army are foot soldiers with poisoned spines. They breed a caste of albino priests able to cast spells. Some of them are deadly assassins.
Like fly, briefly.
Invisible. Venomous. Others.
I fly to lose concentration, slam into the ground.
Of elite warriors, anti-paladins, the Shikath.
Can they really impersonate people?
It's been proven, though it's a long process. They used to kidnap a target, study it for weeks, sometimes months. One of their chosen ones would transform into a perfect duplicate. Upon death, they would return to their original form.
Ah, so we can figure out whether or not someone was a Sorak by killing them.
Cool, take this guy's head.
Well, that's all very scary, but thanks, it's going to help
us. Hit the button, call a meeting.
You're welcome, deputies. If you find anything else connected to the Sor-Akath or their allies, bring it to the temple. Talk to Chancellor Ellen Lark. You will be well rewarded. Whenever you're ready, the council will meet again.
Save a bit on the budget for these statues by not rendering
them
all with
them. It's an honor, deputies.
Who are you?
My name is Maddie Greenisle. I work for the Tower of Knowledge. I'm just a junior aide in the council, but if you ever need to contact my superiors without going through official channels, just see me at the tower, downtown.
Why the sudden interest?
You proved yourselves in the Badlands. Now, we in the
probably holding on to a bunch of faction items.
Value skilled adventurers. If you find anything of historical value, we'll pay well. And, you know, if things go well, we might share some of our own secrets.
All right. We'll think about it.
Can I ask for a minute of your time, deputies?
Sure, why not?
We're in kind of a hurry.
I know.
No, actually,
we
really
won't delay you long. My name is Hedland Shorespell. I represent the Arcanium.
And the Arcanium belongs to the new Empire. Do you really want to be seen talking to us?
My business is magic, not politics. And no, I have no quarrel with you. You may not see us Imperials as friends, but we take the Council very seriously. We are particularly interested in anything from the Old Empire that you might find in the Badlands. Anything from the Manicallon era Arcanium. Even more so. Oh, of course, we'd pay you handsomely for this crown, although I know that's not possible.
You're smarter than you look.
Also quite indifferent to mockery. Anyway, we have an unrivaled trove of magical and other knowledge. Think it's over. You can find me at the Grave Keep's cask.
Really? Not at the embassy?
What can I say? I love Martell's beer, even though it tastes like donkey piss.
So you love donkey piss, is what we're hearing. Donkey piss.
I am a wizard.
Was he spying on us?
Maybe he just agrees about the taste.
Finally, we make it to the door.
Yeah, this is the be prepared to get stopped in town a lot section.
Yep.
Because now all the factions are going to introduce themselves. As soon as you get near them. I will be right back.
Yep.
Would you have a moment, deputies?
All right, but make it quick.
I'll do my best. I am Joyel Foxeye from the Circle of Denantar.
The same magic school where the princess studied.
Quebecois.
Exactly.
Is she a good student?
Listen, the DM was running out of accents to distinguish his NPCs.
And you seemed
to I was about to say, I have an outrageous accent.
I just want you to know that our Grand Master Edvan Denantar has noticed you.
He talked a lot, for sure.
He's a man of great authority. He'd like you to know that our doors are open to you if you'd care to visit us. You can find me at Sunblaze Court.
Interested in Badlands treasures, I suppose, like everyone else?
Well, if you ever come across old spellbooks or spell scrolls, we'd love to see them. In return, we have the largest collection of spells and potion recipes you could ever hope to see.
More than the Arcanium?
They would disagree, but yes. Now, if you were to prefer feeding the new Empire's wizards with more magical knowledge than the Principality, that would be a troubling choice to many on the Council.
Neutrality means we don't treat you any differently than we treat them.
Of course. Neutrality is the rule. Good day to you, deputies.
All right. Certainly hope I don't get stopped by this random person walking over here.
All of a sudden the statue comes to life. Hello, adventurers! It's me, the talking statue!
Our talking statue faction raises a little bit. Okay. You. Let's see if we can make it this far.
You fool.
Clear skies,
I mean, it's a conversation with her, but...
Do you know Arwin Merton, the so-called first scavenger?
Of course.
That's it?
Merton. It's a painful topic for me. I'd rather not talk about him.
Fair enough. Clear skies, my friends. Well, thank you. I guess that's it for us. Stay in the light, my friends.
I'm back.
Welcome back.
You've missed so much. Oh, darn.
Stuff. Yep. Stuff we would probably be selling anyways. I don't really care about the ingredients. A crossbow bolt isn't worth carrying. Okay. Side quests. We gained loot and EXP. Okay, it's only a ton for level. That's the important level. Uh, Does anyone else on the map have an exclamation mark? You do.
Look who's here. The Sorak hunters themselves.
It's Merton, right? Arwen Merton.
Damn right.
First scavenger. Where does that come from?
Long story, kid. Short version.
Which I will not tell you.
The marches to the Badlands. I was one of the first. Now, I'm just the ugliest one left standing.
What should we know about the Badlands? Any advice?
Bring a good cleric with good healing spells. You'll need them.
We have bards close enough.
You're a legend. Why do you seem so sour?
Sour? It's this ale that's
sour. The bard has healing spells.
That's all. The High and Mighty Council. Paying clueless kids like you to go and get killed in the Badlands. But they're not asking good old Arwen. No. Go figure. It's because I got them figured out.
Figured out how?
The Legacy Council is full of it. Acting all united and lovey-dovey while they plot to rob each other. Wouldn't surprise me if some of them were even Soraks in disguise. You know they can shapeshift.
Okay.
Hey, I was right about them hiding in the Badlands, wasn't I?
Alright. Anyone else have an exclamation over their head? What's the chances of us making it to the council?
50-50. Greetings, Sorak Slayers.
Hello.
I am Halman Summer of the Guild of Antiquarians. I'm instructed to invite you to visit us at the Embassy of the Snow Alliance.
You're based at an embassy? I thought the council was neutral.
We don't have a house of our own in Kaer Kiflin, unlike the Tower of Knowledge. How about that for neutrality? Anyway, we'd be interested in any antiquities you might bring back. We pay very well, even for things you might think are worthless.
Like the scavengers?
The scavengers? Well, they'd sell an antique emperor's sword for its metal value. But we can offer more than gold. Antique magical items, for instance. You'll never find their like elsewhere.
Good to know. Thanks for the invitation.
Honorable council members, please take your seats.
Ah, our crown bearer is up again.
Lord Danantar has the floor.
Thank you. I have confirmed that our deputy is indeed magically attuned to the crown. It is an uncommonly powerful attunement, unlike anything I've seen. I strongly recommend against forcing separation.
Chancellor Gormsdotter?
With the council's permission, I'd like to try a little experiment. I have here the gem that Captain Merrin recovered recently. I have reason to believe that it might be... as I suspected. It belongs to the crown.
What have you done? Ow, lady. My fucking face!
No, wait!
Are you ready for a cutscene battle?
Sure, why not? Alright, now to run this guy as incompetently as possible.
This is an unknown hero, thank you very much. Could be anyone.
Anyway, requires level 2 spells. How powerful can it be?
He has 140 hit points. So however powerful that is, he also gets two actions around.
Well, no, he just has three attacks.
No, he actually has two actions. Like, you can see two hits for his action bar. Yeah, wait till his next turn comes around. He actually has two main actions. You can see the number he has on the bottom of his main action bar.
Bottom of his main action bar?
Yeah, on the main action bar where it has the two little, like, glowing pips.
Oh, those things. Oh. Huh.
Yeah, he has two actions. He's still limited to only be able to cast like a single spell per round, etc., but. I think his second action can only be used for like movement, disengage, and regular attacks, but.
Yeah, and he only gets one attack with it. That's not like a proper second action.
No. But he can't, like, do a dash, do a dodge, do a...
It's effectively a free action surge.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
And now for something completely different.
Are you going to faint again?
Any preference?
It's nothing.
I just had a vision.
I guess you didn't agree.
A vision? In an instant?
I
was fighting Sorax, but I wasn't myself.
Then who were you?
A paladin. Powerful. From Tiamar.
That is unsettling. Let the Crown Bearer and the other deputies follow that quest. Find the other gems if you can, but keep us informed. In the meantime, we will formulate a response to the Sorax.
Let's vote.
We're going to write them a sternly worded letter.
Might just work.
Your Royal Highness?
Dear Sorax, please stop.
Oh, pardon me. Yes, I concur.
They did say please.
To which proposition, Your Highness? I mean, I. They should go and find the diamonds, the gems.
So resolved. Let it be recorded. Thank you, honored delegates. The council is now in recess.
What was that? You had a vision.
I can't explain. I just feel it. Anyway, we have a new mission.
All right then. So where are we going, Crown Bearer? I think the Crown knows.
We're going to the Dairy Queen.
All right, so we're going to go outside the gates. I'm going to bend my head down and start running, and we just go wherever the Crown leads us. Life,
a follower of the goddess.
I've heard dumber plans.
We do require your services.
Do we really require their services?
Yeah, their shop. By that, I mean not at the moment. All the gem bearer's intuition to the Dark Castle. The Dark Castle is a theme park.
Whee!
Okay.
A word, please, deputies.
What's up?
The sky.
What's this?
A command word to teleport your party to the city's imperial gate.
Teleport?
We can't do that, I'm pretty sure.
Well, word is that in the Badlands, you may come across functioning major gates. If you do, use this command word and you'll be brought back here. Take note of any command word on the gate you find, and you'll be able to return there the same way.
That's fantastic.
Don't get too excited. So far, no one's found any.
Don't find one?
Right. Well, thanks anyway.
Stay in the lights, Senior Deputies.
You too, Captain.
We actually got there this time. Okay. Now that we've unlocked the next part, let's see if there are any new side quests. Nope. Alright. So, seeing as we're actually in town at the end of a stream, or towards the end of a stream for once, I'm not going to actually leave so I can actually do stuff between streams.
Oh!
Like shopping and such.
There is stuff we can do in town.
There is?
Yeah. Talk to people. There's at least like one or two side quests you can actually get while you're in town.
Do you know from who?
Not off the top of my head? I know one of them involved the scavenger woman, but I don't think it starts with her.
Greetings, deputies. Greetings, deputies.
Your contact. Or Manny. City guard. Merchants. I guess just also dialogue.
Interested in a side job?
What kind of side job?
The kind
this takes place entirely in town, if I recall correctly.
And contacts. In the, shall we say, involuntary gift business.
Involuntary gift business? That's just embarrassing. Say what you mean. The underworld, right?
And there I was trying to be discreet.
Try harder. Suppose I do have the skills and contacts you're looking for.
Go to Annie Bagmorda at the Scavengers. Tell her I send you.
Merton says you've got a problem.
Arwen. What makes you think you can help?
Not saying I can, yet. But, well, I know people.
People who can track down stolen goods.
What kind of goods?
A sword. Imperial. The guard has three diamonds. Probably magical.
Probably? What does it probably do?
Never got a chance to find out.
You offering a reward?
I'll make it worth your while.
Are you not the one supposed to bring back stuff?
Very funny.
Thank you.
Hey, Nell. Still laughing?
Like Masaya herself. You?
Oh, happy as a rat in a granary. Need an ear out.
For?
A nice antique sword with three diamonds. Hear anything?
Something. Talk to Gorim.
So that's your former life, walking the streets.
And cutting the throats of people who cross me.
Kind of curious how this goes if you don't have like a lowlife or a rogue.
I think this is specifically a quest that's only there if you have a lowlife.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Okay, so talk to you.
Hey, Gorim. I'm in the market for a sword. A very particular one.
How particular?
Imperial. Three diamonds in the guard. Probably magical. Sound familiar?
Too expensive for me. I turned him down.
He have a name?
Didn't say. I told him to ask for sure spell at the Gravekeep's cask. The Arcanium has money.
Thanks.
Thank me by buying something?
Another time. But I will.
I'll remember.
I've just got more rations in. You guys don't need traveling rations, right?
We somehow end up with the exact same amount, no matter how many times we travel. It's not because of a cheater or anything, we just have that high of survival.
Yeah, just is a thing.
Hey, Carol.
Back again?
Has anyone been in asking for sure spell?
The Arcanium guy? Yes, as it happens, over there. Still waiting, it seems.
Thanks. I've been looking for you.
I'm waiting for someone, and you're not him. Get lost.
That channel divinity. Go for the intimidate.
Yep.
It's about that very nice sword that you're thinking of selling to head Longshorespell of the Arcanium.
How do you...
Doesn't matter. What matters is, do you want to end up nailed to a door in Fishtown?
What?
You see, the sword was already spoken for when you stole it from the scavengers. And a certain someone's going to be very disappointed if they don't get it as planned. The sort of someone who nails people to doors in Fishtown.
Messiah's crooked dice, I can get it for you.
Just tell me where to find it. Then it might be wise to leave town. I hear the Southern Isles are lovely at this time of year.
It's in Messiah's temple for safekeeping. Ask Nell for a bowl of soup.
Nell? I just talked to him. Oh, I should have known.
Bowl of soup? That's the worst password I've ever heard.
Time to go get a bowl of soup.
Hey, Nell. So, I'm supposed to ask you for,
A bowl of soup?
Oh, you knew.
Of course. Messiah sees all.
And you didn't tell me because...
This was more fun.
For you and Messiah, I'm sure. Well, I won't be a grouch about it.
Oh, Messiah loves to tease a grouch. Ask properly.
Really?
Rules are rules.
Rules? You? Oh, wait. Only when it's fun, right?
You're learning.
All right then, Chaplain Nell. May I please have a bowl of soup?
Comes back with a bowl of soup and a giant sword sticking out.
It's in that chest.
There you go.
This locked chest. I should have known.
The level of whimsy in this town is confounding.
I can't get it.
Make a donation to Messiah for luck.
Well, take it, you crook.
Your coin made Messiah smile.
So each time you pay, it reduces the DC to actually open the chest. And let you do another attempt. You can technically do an attempt with each character without having to pay. But they do have to have thieves' tools in order to actually try and pick it.
Still nothing.
Also, returns the DC is bonkers.
Yes.
Oh.
Until you pay it down.
You probably... Try again.
But once it gets into the reasonable level, you can swap thieves' tools around on people so they can do checks as well. There you go. So about this sword, you can turn this in for money, or you can just keep it.
Right.
Because it is a plus two sword.
Yes, it is a plus two sword. That said, I don't actually have anyone that uses longswords at the moment. Or more specifically... One-handed.
If you keep it around, you can eventually get the one that lets you use non-light weapons for dual wielding.
Yeah. That's one up there. You guys are a little bit more clever.
Yeah, I think there's like a spellcaster way in the back. Oh, maybe not.
There's an evil priest. There's
evil priest. Right. Okay. Yeah. Oh, way up front. He was further back when I did this one. This is a gunner.
Or can you just get countered?
Yep. And yes, this is specifically a quest that's attached to the low life background.
Arcana, evil
How did I miss? Ah! You'll die anyway. I was sure. More coming your way.
Arcana, Evo, Malmis.
That's battle. Walk it off. Arcana, Evo, Malmis. Again, harder! And the winner is me.
You suck. Which backgrounds do we have in the party?
I know we have a spy.
I took scholar.
Scholar, and then whatever you picked for.
I did sellsword. Scholar.
Sellsword. Yeah.
Scholar is not a background.
I'd have to.
Character.
You're low life.
Low life, spy, philosopher, and sellsword.
Philosopher, that was it. Yeah. Philosopher.
Okay, we cannot get this. I'm just checking to see which side quests we can grab.
Ah.
Because they all unlock at different times.
We cannot go that way either.
Okay, right, we can't get any other side quests yet. Not until later on in the story. Please. Background side quests. So yeah, you can either keep the sword, you can turn it in. You get XP and money if you turn it in. If you keep it, it's a +2 longsword.
You probably turn it in, we'll eventually get +2 weapons that are more appropriate.
Yeah.
Also, yeah. EXP.
If we had someone who could use it right now, it might be worth keeping around then turning it in later on once we have an equivalent or a replacement, but...
Yeah.
Since we don't, we can just turn it in now, get the XP and money.
You're back! Did you get it?
Yeah. And you mentioned a reward.
Beside my undying gratitude. All right. Here.
Take this barrel. Yep, let me see those coins. Okay. Alright, so it is like 1:40-ish.
Yep.
Yeah.
So it's about a good stop time, and again, stopping in town actually means I can do stuff between streams other than, I don't know, like sword inventory or such. So, that's all we have for you today. Join us on Saturday for SD... Sunday. Join us on Saturday for Static. Join us on Sunday for, SD Gundam G-Generation Crossrays, where we will be doing Stargazer and almost certainly getting into 00. More specifically, we will not be doing Destiny anymore because we're done with it.
It's done! For free!
There's time now!
Join us on Monday for more Pokemon Infinite Fusion with Shiv, assuming... Internet cooperates again for like 2 weeks
in
a row.
It's been nice. Last couple days.
Join us on possibly other days for things, possibly not. Or everything else still on hiatus? Rest?
Next Tuesday I will be starting something.
Okay. And join us again next week back here for more Celestia, Crown of the Magister. Till then, I'm Vincent.
I'm Shiv.
I'm Brad.
There we go.
I've been the Krampus.
Sorry, Mike.
I'm Hunter Green.
And I'm Vincent. All right. Good night, everyone.
The two Vincents. One of them has to be a Sorak.
Certainly not.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think it means.